हेलो, आई एम मिसेस गीता धुंधुरवाड, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटीज एंड साइंसेस, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन दिस सेशन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द यूज ऑफ क्लिचेस इन इंग्लिश ग्रामर. दिस इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, student will be able to apply English grammar effectively in their day-to-day communication. So, in this session, I will discuss on all these points, that the introduction, then definition, characteristics of glitches and use of glitches in sentences. So, introduction. While communicating, it is very important to choose words carefully. Unclear and careless language affects our ability to communicate effectively. So, it is very important to recognize words or expressions that weaken our messages. Clichés are the words that affect our effective communication. So, let us discuss what is the meaning of the term glitch. So, the definition of glitch. A glitch is a saying, image or idea which has been used so much that it sounds terribly uncreative. The word glitch, it was originally French for the sound of printing plate which prints the same over and over. So, glitches. Using glitch is considered bad writing and speaking because they make it sound like you didn't put any thought into your words. Good writers and good speakers try to thoughtful and original language rather than glitches in their work. So now we are going to discuss about some of the characteristics of glitch. The first characteristics, glitches are by definition common and overused. They can be found frequently, but you may not notice them because we take them for granted. See the examples. Every cloud has a silver lining. This glitch we are using in our day-to-day communication. The meaning of it is that even in bad situation, you can usually find something good. The next example is easy as a pie. And the meaning is very easy. The third example is take a chill pill. The meaning of this glitch is to relax. The next characteristics, glitches are sometimes ideas, images, or character rather than phrases. And examples are, the first one, the damsel in distress. The meaning is, a young attractive woman is incompetent and in need of someone else to rescue. The second example is, the superhero. And the meaning is, one who saves the damsel in distress, often strong and good looking. So, sometimes clichés are ideas or images or maybe in the form of character. The next characteristics is, clichés tend to simplify and dramatize. These clichés make casting seem shallow and therefore uninteresting. So the example is, to describe falling in love. To describe falling in love, the cliché is used as, she fell head over heels. The meaning of this cliché is that we are describing that falling in love. He or she is falling in love. The next characteristics is, clichés are very common in popular in books, poems, movies, TV shows, speeches and advertisements. Many clichés have their origins in classics like Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. So this is the example. A rose by any other name would smell as sweet. Then all that glitters is not gold. This example is from Merchant of Venice. Next one is, jealousy is the green-eyed mobster. This example is from Othello. The next characteristics is, although clichés should usually be avoided, they can be used for comedic effect or in works where original or deep thoughts are not expected, such as TV shows or movies like romantic comedies and superheroes blockbuster. The example, Alive and Well is a cliché from the movie The Last Song. Here are some of the examples of clichés. The first example is, all that glitters is not gold. Then, all for one and one for all. The next one is, he has his tail between his legs. The next one is, and they all lived happily ever after. The next example is, read between the lines. Then, in the nick of time, just a matter of time. Next one is, brave as lion. Then all is fair in love and war. And the last one is, a waste of time. All these clichés we are using in our day-to-day communication. Although critics advise against clichés, they are important because they express ideas and thoughts that are widespread and common within a culture. Hence, The phrase cliche but true. Yet in our culture, we tend to dislike cliches. Hence the phrase cliche but true. Yet in our culture, we tend to dislike cliches because we place a high value on creativity, originality, and cleverness rather than on repetition and using other people's words. So, that's why cliches are avoided in our good writing. So, these are the references, these are the links I have used to make my PPT. Thank you and have a nice day.